You are listening to The Voice of the Gospel, a proclamation of the Holy Gospel by Wisdom Ministries.
January 15th, Friday. Let's begin this day with the blessings of God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. When he returned to Capernaum after some days, it was reported that he was at home. So many gathered around that there was no longer room for them, not even in front of the door. And he was speaking the word to them. Then some people came, bringing to him a paralyzed man, carried by four of them. And when they could not bring him to Jesus because of the crowd, they removed the roof above him, and after having dug through it, they let down the mat on which the paralytic lay. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Son, your sins are forgiven." Now some of the scribes were sitting there, questioning in their hearts, "Why does this fellow speak in this way? It is blasphemy. Who can forgive his sins but God alone?" At once Jesus perceived in his spirit that they were discussing these questions among themselves, and he said to them, "Why do you raise such questions in your hearts? Which is easier, to say to the paralytic, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Stand up and take your mat and walk'? But so that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the paralytic, "I say to you, stand up, take your mat and go to your home." And he stood up and immediately took the mat and went out before all of them, so that they were all amazed and glorified God, saying, "We have never seen anything like this." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. My dear friends, after some days, Jesus returns to Capernaum from his refuge in the desert. Immediately, the crowds gather in and around the house where he is staying. It is so crowded that there is no room to get in. The house is not identified and it is not important. In the early Christian communities, they gathered in one house to celebrate the Eucharist. Jesus was there among them. Some people are inside the house with Jesus. Others are still on the outside. The four men arrived carrying the paralytic friend. They were anxious to get Jesus. Seeing no way in, they went up by the outside staircase on to the flat roof, removed a few tiles and let the man down right at the feet of Jesus. Jesus is touched by their faith, trust and confidence in him. It is one of the essential conditions for healing. Jesus says to the paralyzed man, "Child, your sins are forgiven." This must have come as a surprising statement to the paralytic. He had come for healing, not forgiveness. Some scribes who were also present were not only surprised, they were deeply shocked. "Why does this man speak that way? Only God can forgive sins." They are perfectly right, but their eyes are closed to drawing the obvious conclusion. They don't see because they do not want to see, because even worse, they think they can see. Jesus then challenges them, "Which is easier, to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or 'Get up, pick up your bed and walk'? Raise that man, raise up and pick up the mat and went." Of course, telling a person their sins are forgiven is certainly easier, but does the fact that Jesus could heal the paralytic instantly also mean that his sins are forgiven? We need to realize the close links the Jews of time made between sin and the sickness. Many kinds of sickness were seen as a punishment for personal sin or even the sins of parents. This man then was understood to be paralyzed because of some sin in his life. If Jesus could clearly remove the illness, then the cause of the illness was also being taken away. Yes. In these times, we are beginning to realize that there can be a link between our sicknesses and the way we act and relate with people. We know that there is mutual influence between our thinking and our attitudes, feelings and behavior. Many sicknesses are known to be psychosomatic, the result of stress or an imbalance in our relationship with others, our work, our environment. Yes, the wholeness is something we need to pray and work for. The paralyzed man represents all those who are paralyzed in other ways, who are not able to behave with the freedom that a well-integrated person has. And that integration and wholeness concerns our relationship with the others, with ourselves, with our environment, and of course, with God. Amen. May God bless us.